So now we are live also.
It's preparing, sir. Just give
it's
it
preparing, yeah, that's right.
So now we are live also.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, it is there. It is there.
Yes,
it's preparing, yeah, that's right. Correct.
In another 10 minutes, sir, we will begin the session. Kavita, please stay on mute. Don't unmute yourself. Please mute. Stay on mute, please.
So now we are live also.
Yes, sir.
Correct.
In another 10 minutes, sir, we will begin the session. Kavita, please stay on mute.
Hello.
Thank you, Kavita. Keep okay, yourself sir. Muted. Mohit, can you do one thing?
Please, sir. Tell me.
You make me co-host.
Sir,
so the details are visible to me.
Sir, I only have one host.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
There are 228 participants right now. We'll okay. just wait for another 5 minutes.
Yeah, another 20. Let's 250 is the final, no?
500, sir.
500. Oh, 500. Oh, that's good. Then there's no issue.
We will, sir. We will start exactly at 4 p.m. We will start at 4 p.m. Sir.
Chai pila dena beech mein. Kisi bhi time. Kisi bhi time pila dena. 4 baje to meeting shuru.
Bindu. Hello. बोले मम्मा को एक कप चाय दे देंगे चलो हम बोल देते हैं
अरे नहीं नहीं मुझे मैं कहाँ तैयार हूँ पागल घर में बैठी हूँ मैं तुझे पता है मेरा बैक साइड का लगा हुआ क्या करूँ कट
Kavita, please stay on mute. I will have no other choice.
Yeah, sorry. Tell, batao.
Kavita, please stay on mute. I will have no other choice but to take you off the meeting. Please stay on mute. All the participants except Rajesh sir, Professor R.K. Chadha, and the official host, please stay on mute.
हाँ तो मैंने mute कर दिया लेकिन अपने आप automatically unmute हो गया.
Who is he speaking?
There are many who have. Amrita. Lapita.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
please, all the participants, keep your audio or mic mute.
So probably we should do one session on how to participate in a Zoom meeting in one of
the... No, you need to tell them.
Yeah.
Please brief the participants.
Yes, sir. In tomorrow's email, probably we will have it in bold.
We should have one more slide for how to participate.
Yeah. But it's by and large, sir, in control. We have 313 participants now. It's okay. Great by the minute. So people have really started pooling in. It's really good to see. Welcome you all. Just stay on mute and we'll begin in another 4 minutes. The guest speaker, the host, the convener and the co-convener, sir, all of us have joined in. We are just waiting for more participants to join for another 4 minutes and we will begin this session. Whatever questions you have, please make sure you type them in the chat box. We are closely monitoring the chat and we will try to answer as many questions as we can. But for in our effort to do this in an organized manner, I request all of you to just stay on mute. Arun Shalia, please stay on mute. Gagandeep, please.
संजय
संजय ऑडियो का मीनिंग क्या होता
है
Ajay sir, there seems to be some noise from your side.
Yes, wait. Thank you.
request the participants once and for the final time, please stay on mute. पार्टिसिपेंट से अनुरोध है कि वो प्लीज म्यूट पर रहें. इन ऑर्डर टू डू दिस इन एन इफेक्ट
हु इज डूइंग दिस
I'll just share my screen again. Just give me a second. So we are good to go. Rajesh sir, off to you. Please.
Thank you, Mohit. Thank you very much. Namaskar. We have this webinar on 21st century information skill. I welcome you all. The speaker, Professor Chachakha. Please mute the video. Whoever is playing sound.
Rajesh sir, just give me a second. Yes, sir. You are good to go.
Okay. Thank you, Mohit. Thank you very much. Namaskar, Mitro. I have seen the participation list and my audio is echoing.
Yes, sir. Wait. Sir, are you connected on two devices?
I'm connecting.
Just connect on one. I'll mute one of them, sir. Yes, sir. Please go ahead.
Now I can.
Yes, sir. It's better.
Okay. Fine. So, friends, I have seen participation list, and we have participants from throughout the country, from every nook and corner of the country. We have participants. Now I invite the host of this webinar, Dr. R.K. Sharma, to please formally welcome the participants, the speaker of the day. Dr. R.K. Sharma, please.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir,
you are audible.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Rajesh Singhji, for giving me this opportunity to give a formal welcome address to this 21st century information skills. I'm really delighted to be here today to be part of this first ever webinar series conducted by Delhi Library Association. So on the behalf of the Delhi Library Association, I extend my warm welcome to all of you, and particularly my friend Dr. R.K. Chadda, who has agreed to deliver a address to the participants using this webinar skills and competencies required for LIS professionals. I welcome Dr. Chadda you, and thank you very much for agreeing to our request at a short notice. Dr. Chadda is not an ordinary person. Let me tell you, he is a daily pride for we people that we have persons like him in the profession. And you see, he has attained the highest position, you see, in the country, working with Parliament Library as, and he retired as additional secretary. So I think everybody knows him but we are very thankful to him that he has joined this webinar and he has graced this occasion. I'm welcoming to all other speakers who will be speaking in the next 3 days, Dr. Jaideep Sharma ji, Nabi Hassan, and our colleague in DLA who will be speaking on bibliometry. So I welcome all of the speakers who will be speaking during this 4 days. I also welcome all the EC members of the Delhi Library Association and the members of this refereed organization who has collaborated with us and given us all the facilities. I would like to welcome the participants who have really joined, because there are a lot of webinars going on, but they have joined us. And if I'm not wrong, because I'm told that more than 700 participants will be joining this webinar. So it's really very encouraging for Delhi Library Association. Now, let me tell you, because Delhi Library Association is a very old library association and rather oldest library association in India, established in 1939. And it was headed and you see participated by all the luminaries of library and information science people. So if I start taking name, it will be a long list, but let me tell you, even Dr. Ranganathan was part of this Delhi Library Association, and a lot of other luminaries, they were directly or indirectly associated with Delhi Library Association. So we are really proud of them. And then this Delhi Library Association, the main job of Delhi Library Association since its inception was to impart education. And we have been, you see, in teaching since 1955. The certificate course in library science was started in 1955. And since then, more than 7,000 students have passed out in that particular course, and they are working in different libraries in the country. And similarly, we do have a diploma in information technology. And then we do have the study center of IGNU also for the last many years. I think we started in 2004, the IGNU study center for Billy Vassy and Emily Vassy. So all the academic or the teaching, you see, activities are happening in this organization. So we are not really new, but we have been doing all in a conventional way. So this is the first time that we have to shift to this online learning or online education. And I really tried to talk to my colleagues in the DLA, and we thought that let us start having our classes using online technology. And in IGNU, we have been successfully providing the classes, means the online classes, and our teachers, really, they are helping all these students. And I should appreciate, because nowadays we do have, you see, users, means the newcomers, they are all well aware about the new technologies. So for them, it's nothing new. They are really, they have already adapted to the new technologies. And you see, we call them the natives, the digital natives. So we have to really serve the society, the newcomers, with this new technology so that we can meet their demand. You see, we have anticipated a lot of you see changes due to this COVID-19. Before that, we were doing, means we are shifting or changing towards new technologies, but right away, this particular pandemic really made we people, forced we people to really shift to this new technology, like online lecturing and all that. A lot of UC changes has taken places in the student behavior, let me tell you. And a lot of shift from conventional lectures to online lectures or education we have been noticing it. And teaching and research has also got a lot of UC changes. So why I am mentioning all this? Because we are running in the 21st century of information skills, means the information skills we need in our new entrants of the library profession. I am happy that all this, the entire group of participants, actually, that is the uniqueness of this particular webinar, that we have invited all the students and the young professionals, because they are the first entrants to this library profession, and we wanted really to share their views, share our views with them. And luckily, we do have very good library experts with me people. They will be telling them that how they will feel when they join this profession, what are the prerequisites to fulfill while be in this profession, what are the passions and skills required for this passion. So Dr. Chadha, Dr. Sharma, and all other UC speakers, they will be speaking on that, so that the people or the newcomers, the students, particularly the young generation, they can be enlightened that what type of profession they are entering and how they can do their innings successfully. So by saying all this, because I don't want to take much of your time, because I want that we should, I'm really ready to listen Dr. Chadha, because he will be delivering a lot of new things to you people. I'm sure you will be benefited. Please patiently listen his lecture. And on behalf of everything, I think I again welcome you all. I have seen Professor Lakshmana Rao. He was in the, I think he's also participating, and all other senior professionals who are really attending this webinar. I'm really thankful to all of them, and I welcome you again, and please be patient and hear what Dr. Chadha will be telling you in a few minutes. And now, thank you very much, and over to Dr. Rajeshji for further.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. I have some requests to all the participants. Please don't do what whosoever is trying to blur the screen, because we are identifying such peoples and they will be thrown out. So please don't do that. All the participants, please don't do that. Let me ask if my voice is clear to all of you.
Yes.
All the participants, please tell me my voice is clear.
If
it is not clear, you send me a message. Otherwise, you are not required to unmute yourself. Please learn how to behave in a webinar. Okay. Please keep all of you, please keep yourself muted. And whatever message you are typing, we are keeping a close watch on it, and we will respect your message, and we will intervene, and we will try to find out the solution. But whosoever is just simply blurring the screen, please stop it. It is not bearable. Be sure that you are not doing anything like that. Please, all of you, make it a point that this is not repeated again. Thank you very much. Now I invite my friend Janin Narayan Singh. Please join us and kindly introduce the personality of Professor R.K. Chadha to the audience. Please introduce him.
Sure, sir.
Namaskar.
भारतीय लाइब्रेरी प्रोफेशन में जो हमारे आज के स्पीकर हैं उनको इंट्रोडक्शन की कोई ज़रूरत नहीं है, लेकिन हमारे बीच कुछ बच्चे हैं जो पीजीडी लाइन एमबीए के हैं, उनके लिए मैं एक ब्रीफ तरह का इंट्रोडक्शन देना चाहता हूँ. एन एकम्प्लिस्ड सीनियर गवर्नमेंट ऑफिसर्स विद अ विजन एंड लीडरशिप इनसाइट्स टू द स्ट्रिक्टली प्लान्ड डायरेक्ट एंड एक्सिक्यूट इंस्टीट्यूशनल ऑपरेशंस. Dr. Ravindra Kumar Chadha had superintendent as additional secretary, Parliament of India, Lok Sabha Secretariat. Dr. Ravindra Kumar Chadha is presently engaged as professor at Malwanchal University. In addition, his current assignments include एडजंक्ट फैकल्टी एट वनस्थली विद्यापीठ यूनिवर्सिटी, मेंबर ऑफ गवर्निंग बोर्ड ऑफ इंटरनेट एंड बिल्डिंग कमिटी ऑफ इलेक्शन कमीशन ऑफ इंडिया. He was a member of the Indian delegation to World Trade Organization Parliamentary Conference, Geneva, 2014, Inter-Parliamentary Seminar for ASEAN Parliament on Prevent and Responding to Violence Against Women and Girls, 2011, and Secretary to Parliamentary Delegation to Iran. A widely traveled professional, he was invited to USA during 1993 and 2002 under International Digital Leadership Program, IBLP, and also to Germany by Goethe Institute. Delivered several keynote addresses, invited talk, including at PhD Chamber of Commerce and Industry, Royal Society of Chemistry, and a number of national international conferences. Dr. Chadha has worked with several parliamentary committees, including Defense Library, Welfare of SC and ST, Urban Development, Estimate, ETC Lok Sabha Television Channel, LSTV, Computer Division, Editorial and Translation Service, Printing Service, Press and Public Relations, Audio Video Visual Unit, Parliament Museum and Archive, ETC. Professor Chadha is a recipient of ICTT Lifetime Achievement Award for Distinguished Service in 2019, DLA Lifetime Achievement Award 2018, Manav Rachna CL Lifetime Achievement Award 2020, LPA Lifetime Achievement Award 2019, Master Mutilal Sangai Award 2009, Satkal National Award 2006. इसके अलावा सर जो है बहुत ही बहुमुखी प्रतिभा के हैं. जब आप रूबरू होंगे उनका बहुत सारा पहलू जो बच्चे नहीं जानते हैं वो उनको देखने को मिलेगा. धन्यवाद.
थैंक यू ज्ञानेंद्र जी. हेलो
जी सर.
यस सर, वी कैन हियर.
थैंक यू ज्ञानेंद्र जी. नाउ आई इनवाइट द स्पीकर ऑफ द डे प्रोफेसर आर के चड्ढा टू प्लीज ज्वाइन एंड डिलीवर द स्पीच ऑफ द डे. प्रोफेसर आर के चड्ढा प्लीज. I believe that audio is very much clear to all the participants. There is no issue right now. Please don't unmute yourself. Don't unmute yourself. If there is any problem, you message me. You are not supposed to unmute yourself. Please learn to behave in a webinar. Please, all the participants. Professor R. K. Chadha, sir, please join us.
Good afternoon, friends.
In fact,
it's my privilege to be with you today afternoon under the aegis of Delhi Library Association. I must thank Dr. R. K. Sharma, Dr. Rajesh Singh, Dr. Jayanendra Ji for giving me this opportunity. I'm really overwhelmed that almost 500 people have joined this webinar, and I'm sure I'll be able to do some justice to you. Friends, since I was a professional work almost for 40 years in the libraries, not only in the library, but in the bureaucracy also. I have very closely worked in Indian bureaucracy. And that's why this subject, skills and competency, is very close to my heart. When Professor Sharma asked me to deliver a talk on this, I was really, since it's so close to me, I really and readily agreed on that. What I will be talking to you today is not the theory of the, subject, that what are the skills, what are the competencies and all. What I'll try to talk from my heart. I'll try to talk from my experience. I'll try to give you certain tips that how you can grow in the profession if you are just entering in the profession, or if you are already in the profession, how you can reach to the heights. Because the only way to reach to better positions, to better jobs, you have to work hard. But at the same time, you have to work very smartly as well. If you look into the Charles Darwin quotation, it says that it is not the strongest or the most intelligent who will survive, but those who can best manage the change. Now, today we are living in a very disruptive technology era. Now, what is this disruptive, technologies or innovations? These are such innovations which even you have not heard of or thought of earlier. And they suddenly come and takes over or the sweep over the things. People feel it's a, curse, right? Chinese proverb always say it is a curse. But I personally feel it's a great opportunity for us. This particular thing gives us so much of opportunity that we can contribute in the world. Once we are here in the professions, once we are here in the system, we can contribute a lot. Now, just to explain you what these disruptive technologies are, think of Uber. Now, Uber was not known to anybody since, about 10 years back or 5 years back even. They don't own even a single car, but they are the largest taxi service in the world. Airbnb, Paytm, you must have heard Paytm. Think of this delivery system, Amazon, Flipkart, and all these things. Today we are talking about entertainment because we all are quarantined at home. We are not allowed to go out. So we are, able to enjoy Netflix. And the best part is webinars, what we can enjoy. Now today, if you talk to Mercedes-Benz, who are the best car manufacturers in the world, they say they have competition with Tesla, Google, Apple, and Amazon. They don't have a competition with the car makers, but they have competition with the IT industry, the knowledge industry. So that is the kind of technologies coming up which can disrupt any system. And since these technologies are available everywhere, don't think library is not touched by it. Library is surrounded by disruptive technologies. Whole lot of disturbances, whole lot of new technologies are coming and disturbing the libraries or, trying to change the view of the library. So what are these technologies? See, I'll tell you one thing. These technologies will never stop. They will go on. New things will come. New systems will come. And we have to amend ourselves, we have to change ourselves, we have to modify ourselves to suit to those systems. Online education. In fact, I was, on January 10th itself, I was delivering a talk in India International Center in a panel. And there we were talking about online education or education 4.0. We expected that it will take some time to come to the India, but due to COVID-19, this has already came to India. The online education is now within the system. The publishing pattern will totally change. What we are seeing a publication system will be totally revised, reviewed. Boundaries, now the data protection will be a very important issue. Privacy of data. My data should not go out. So these are the things which are coming up in the new world. Economies are changing. The global economic scenario will depend on the knowledge industries. They will not depend now on the productions, but they will depend on the knowledge industries. So the whole scenario in the world is changing. The whole life pattern is changing. So when we see this kind of a pattern, I have amended, that Darwin's theory a little extra, I have gone one line ahead and I say, it is not only the best who can manage the change, but who can change with time, who is creative, innovative, and keep reinventing. You have to keep reinventing. You have to be on and on thinking new ideas, new things. Fun. Now, LIS professionals, my dear friends, if you want to remain in business, you want to remain competitive, you want to remain viable, then you have to re-envision yourself every day. And this is for all. It is not that only the managers or the librarians or the senior professionals has to look into. It has to be from each and everybody. what is happening today in the libraries, especially in the Indian library scenario. What we are trying to do is, we are using our old methods, yesterday methods, and trying to give service to today's user, the Google user. Today user is very different. And to this IT savvy user, we are trying to use the old methods, and we expect that we will be able to give the modern services to them. You cannot keep on doing this thing. You have to change. And if you don't, then there can be alternatives which can come into. So we need to shift from techniques. At present, you know, if I look into Indian scenario, it is more dependent on the library techniques or IT techniques than to services. The focus has to shift from techniques to services. We have to just think of services and nothing else. Friends, what is more important or most important today is human skills. This is our key resource. All other resources we can manage if our key resource, that is human resource, is taken care. If our human resource is up to date, they are amenable to change, they are following the modern practices, certainly we can do wonders. We can think of all other factors becomes, you know, less important. The human factor is the most important or the key factor. So what we should do, how we should do. The first very thing is, the moment we go to our library, to go to our office, we should take it as a challenging day. Every day should be a challenge for us. It's not that girte, padte, uthte hue we are going to office as if there is a liability to go to library. Again, same book, same people, same environment. No. We should take every day as a challenge. Every day is taken as a new day for us, and we come up with new ideas, new concept. We modify certain things. We do some innovation, and that's how our life should be. We have to. I call everyone who is working in a library is a library leader. The leader definition is very different. It is not the leader what we understand, the neta type of things, or you know, who has to lead. A leader is a leader who has to participate, who has to be the part of the system. So every one of us is a part of the system, and we have to come out from our comfort zone. We are enjoying. In fact, what happens is we go to office, spend 8 hours, enjoy wild over our time, and come back in the evening. And we relax. We have a, you know, come into a system. That system goes on and on and on, and we spend years and months and years, and finally we retire, come out from the services, or we change the job. So as a library leader, as I said, every one of you is a library leader. So as a library leader, you have to think differently. You have to think in a new creative plan. You have to be visionary. Keep on inventing. Every day there should be idea. New idea should be coming. New experiment should go on. And this idea, which is very important factor today, a simple idea can change the whole life. Look into Hotmail, WhatsApp, Google, Facebook, Airbnb, Uber, Oyo, all. So this is what is, you know, a simple idea. If you bring, you invent, implement. It's not just getting an idea. You have to implement it also. And that can change a life. Now people say, how I will get the ideas? The only way to get those ideas, the only way that which will develop your thinking, the only way which will make you a kind of a person who can do certain things new is the reading, the education. Almost all the world's highest professional achievers have one thing in common. I'll give you certain examples later on. And that one thing is, it is not intelligence, It is not their luck, but their habit of reading. Today, the most profitable investment if you can make is to develop your skills, to read, to study, and this will give you new ideas. It will expand your horizons. It will reveal new inner vistas, and you will get more and more ideas just by reading. I give you an example. There are two persons, Charlie Munger and Warren Buffett. Warren Buffett, we all know. Now, these are the topmost investors of the USA, rather of the world. Rather. And if you look into their biography, in their working, they say only one thing, that we got all these ideas, we got all this money, we all got everything due to our reading habits. He says it is not the smartest or most intelligent or most hardworking person or a learning machine. You have to learn. You have to keep on learning. Buffett reads 500 pages every day and he is the best investor of the world. So this is what gives you an idea. I hope you have heard the name of Elon Musk. Elon Musk was a very ordinary child born in South Africa, and people used to make, you know, his colleagues, his friends used to make joke of him. And, you know, poor guy, since he, you know, people used to tease him, he used to sit in the corner and read science fiction books. And today Musk is CEO of Tesla. You all know Tesla is one of the world's best car making company. Their cars are the costliest car, electric cars. Basically, they are in the electric car business. This is the man who is talking about rockets, who is saying that I will set up a colony on Mars. Agar rehna hai, toh Mars mein jaake rahenge. OpenAI is another company he has launched. His company, this PayPal was his company. So he is in infrastructure. He is in so many things and all modern things. And he says, I have learned all these things from...
Ravindra sir, can I please hold you for a second?
Yes.
Yes, sir. Sir, I need to switch off the annotation because somebody is trying to...
I know. You can do that.
Just give me a second, sir. Just a second, please.
Yeah.
Please stop. I'm stopping your screen sharing for a second.
Okay.
No only problem. For a second, sir.
No problem. Viewers, I hope I am not too fast because the time is very limited.
No, sir. It's perfect, sir.
Okay.
No, it's perfect.
Because Rajesh ji ne bahut kam samay diya hai. Otherwise, this subject is so interesting that I can talk for hours together on the topic. It's so interesting. So, you know, like I'm not able to give you.
Sir, one thing, sir. You can continue. Yeah. You can continue.
Okay. Okay.
Sir, please,
you can continue
sir.
As much as you want.
Okay, dear. Thank you. Now, when we talk about Elon Musk, if you see on the screen, 1999, he started a PayPal company, that something like Paytm kind of a company. SpaceX, where he's talking about taking people to the space. He's the person who started talking about rockets, which can be, you know, reusable rockets kind of a thing. And this, he says, I have learned all these things from the books. If you read the last line of the newspaper, he says, kitabe jine mask kamyabi ka shrey dete hain. And he very clearly said, I learned how to make rockets only through the books. And Tesla cars, as I said, it's the best electric cars in the world, and the costliest electric cars in the world, the Neuralink and what not. And all credit goes to the books. Another gentleman, what happened? Screen is not moving, dear. आ गया। अनदर बिल गेट्स, आई एम श्योर यू ऑल हैव हर्ड बिल गेट्स, हु इज ही, द रिचेस्ट मैन ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. ही गिव्स दिस क्रेडिट टू टू थिंग्स, कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स एंड रीडिंग स्किल्स. बड़ा सिंपल फॉर्मूला ही सेज, सीधा साधा फॉर्मूला है, अच्छे कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स और किताबें पढ़ना. ही रीड्स अबाउट मोर देन 50 बुक्स इन अ ईयर. ही इज सच अ बिजी मैन, ही इज सच अ बिग मैन, बट स्टिल ही इज नॉट लीविंग हिज रीडिंग हैबिट्स. बिल गेट्स एंड देन अनदर मार्क जकरबर्ग, यू ऑल नो, ही अगेन सेज दैट रीडिंग एंड रीडिंग. I don't know how many of you have seen the film Wednesday by Nasiruddin Shah, where he has, you know, created kind of a, he used to talk to the police commissioner and people and all this thing. And he said finally that all these tricks I have learned, how to save myself, how nobody can identify me, that how I am talking, from where I am talking, which phone I am using and all. It is all I have read from the books. So this is the power of the books. This is the power of information. And so what I'm trying to say today is the first lesson or first oath which we have to take, that we have to keep updating ourselves. We have to keep learning. We have to become learning machine. And you don't get full time, you don't get sufficient time to read a book. There are a lot of apps. There are a lot of things in the on the internet which allows you, which gives you a gist of a book, and you can read a book in 15 minutes. Like a complete gist is given either in an audio form, video form, or even a printed form. There are a number of sites, and this is one of them, Blinklist. So you can do that. When you're talking about investment, people come to, you know, if you go to big investors, if they even you come to me and ask, where should I invest my money or my time or my energy, I will say, invest in yourself. The best investment today is investing in yourself. Not keeping money in banks, not keeping wasting your time here and there, but go on updating yourself. Go on upgrading your skills. Go on upgrading your ideas. Go on getting new and new ideas. Go on doing the innovations. So you are investing in yourself. And this investment is the safest investment on the earth. And the next important thing which comes is you have to set the goal. Unless until you set the goal in your life, you cannot achieve it. If today I have to achieve something, I must first set it, then target it, work for it, and finally goal will be achieved, I am sure. Look into Michael Jordan, one of the highest scorer of basketball. He says, I have missed more than 9,000 shots in my career. I have lost almost 300 games. 26 times I have been trusted to take the game. Winning shot I lost. So this man worked so hard. His target was, I want to be the biggest basketball player. And there are a number of examples. People, if they decide to crack an UPSC exam, they work for it, target it, and then they achieve it. So this is how you have to target yourself. So let me come to the libraries. The libraries are changing. As I already said, today we are in the Google user. We are having a Google user. The user is totally different. He is totally IT savvy. The system is changing. And even the libraries are changing. The libraries, you know, now are not those libraries which are full of shelves, journals and all. Rather, we are talking about the study spaces, discussion spaces, MOOC study spaces, cafes, use of technologies, use of laptops and all in the libraries. So library scenario is changing. So I personally feel, you know, like we have a kind of a reference desk, a traditional system of reference desk. What is the need of that? Why can't the staff keep on moving in the library and look into that who is having a problem, identify the person, and then give him the guidance, try to help him. Create different kind of spaces in the library. We should develop the new skills, which are, you know, the expert guidances, scholarly communications and all. Later, I'll be coming to that. But we have to think differently. As I already said, human factor is the prime factor for us. And that should be taken care on that. So what should be taken care? There are two things which are very important. One is self-development and then institutional development. And both are dependent on each other. If you develop yourself, institute gets benefited. If institute develops you or institute makes an environment for further development, institute becomes advanced, then you automatically get developed. So this is a win-win situation for both of us. But yes, we have certain friends, certain dear friends who have capacity to do it, but they don't want to deliver. They are busy with their own politics, their own, you know, like a kind of environment. They feel we are happy. I hear a lot of people saying, "Arre saab, bahut masti hai hamare to, kaam hi nahi karna padta. I go in the morning and come back in the evening, no work. Or hardly I work for 1 hour. I personally feel they should be ashamed of themselves. And we should be ashamed of such people. If I am going to office, I am working in the system for 8 hours. I must give my best during 8 hours. And believe me, any successful person or the successful person is only that which goes extra mile. If you want to be successful in your profession, if you want to succeed in your system, you have to go extra mile. If you are doing the job which your system has given you or your boss has given you, and then you feel that is your duty to complete the job and go away, then you are also one of the ordinary worker in the normal worker. If you want to grow, if you want your system should grow, you have to go extra mile. And this extra mile is very important in life. If I sometimes tell you the stories how I grew in my life, I used to work for the projects when I was with the National Institute of Design, which was not part of my library job, till 12 o'clock in the night, 2 o'clock in the night, travel here and there just to get the information, get the things. So this is how you have to work. You have to prove your worth. You have to prove your existence in the system. Even when I took the entry in the parliament, the first thing I did was, I started, you know, like looking into those opportunities which other people were not touching. And there we succeeded. So you have to go extra mile. Development, you know, like talking that, oh, this is not my job, or that is not the job of library, or not the job of librarian, then fine. That is what the system will give you back. So you have to transform yourself. You have to learn from each other. Share your values, develop a teamwork, commitments, enhancement of participation, cooperation. The system, you know, the old age system that what I do, I should not tell others, has gone. Today, if I do something, I help my friends to learn that, and then knowledge should progress further. If I have gone up to X level, the next person should take me to the next further level. And the further level, and the further level. This is how. You might have seen on the internet, you pose your problem, even if you have a smallest problem, till day before yesterday, my camera was not working on my laptop. I had a problem, so I just went to the net, and I tried to solve it, still I could not resolve, so I put a query on Quora, and then somebody told me how to do it, and within 5 minutes, I could set my camera. Now, what was his interest? No interest. But this is how we have to help each other, how we have to work in a team, crowdsourcing, learning from each other. So what I see in my library conferences, I have attended practically a whole lot of conferences. What I see is people will talk. They will talk, oh, this is the technology, RFID, new technology. Everybody is giving a lecture on RFID. What is RFID? How it works? This. It has no meaning at all. what is or what is social networking? Oh, this is Facebook, this, that, and it has no meaning. What we have to talk is what I have learned, what I have implemented, where I failed, where I succeeded. When I attended conferences at American Library Association, I think you must be knowing the ALA conferences are normally attended by 30,000 to 40,000 professionals. It's such a huge affair. Or IFLA conferences. The people talk only about their experience. They talk what they did, what new thing they implemented, what was the problem in implementing those things, how they succeeded or how they failed. They are not ashamed of their failure also. If they fail, they openly say, okay, I did this, I failed. So this is how you have to collaborate. And this abilities, once you put it into the institution, certainly the institute also get developed. Now, after saying all this thing, after giving you all this, background material, there are certain skills which we as a librarian has to pick up time to time. And I can broadly categorize into two categories, professional skills and personal skills. Now, professional skills, today, in today's world, what exactly we are looking for? As I said, technology is invading. So we have to develop those skills. I can't say that I don't know technology. Now today, if more than 500 people or 1500 people have joined this webinar, that means they have understood this simple technology and they have joined. You all have worked for it. You must have worked a little bit for it. Believe me, this technology is new for everyone. Every day technology is changing. So, wheresoever you start, whensoever you start, it is new. It is new for you. It is new for a computer expert. It is new for me. I may be expert in a lot of things, but when a new thing comes, even for this webinar, I have to learn first. How I have to present, I have to do. Because I may be very good in these computers and all, but I didn't know this much, this particular thing. So every day things are changing. So don't feel that I don't know this technology. I am very poor in the technology. Technology is very simple. Technology, I remember about 25 years back, I went to Punjab University. And they wanted to automate their library and they called me as an external expert. And you know, this in the afternoon, a whole lot of library professionals gathered around me and they said, sir, hum computer kaise use karenge? That was the time when computer was new for everybody, because I was in this system, so I was lucky. Otherwise, it was new. And then, I gave them only one line. I said, and there were a lot of ladies in that group, who were even some of them were very aged also, 50 plus. I told them, if you can handle your washing machine at home, you can handle computer also. It is as simple as handling a washing machine. I'm talking about automatic washing machine. As simple as handling an automatic washing machine is computer handling is same. That means the uses of technology is very simple. The technology developers are making your life so simple that it is very simple to learn technology. So don't be afraid. Tomorrow, if I have to create an institutional repository of my institute, it is very simple. It is as simple as you have learned for a webinar. It is so simple. Tomorrow, I have to set up a web page for my institute. It is equally simple. So don't be afraid of this technology. This technology is very friendly. Only thing is, you have to be working with it. You have to work closely, very closely with it. I remember in 1991, I think, when I got the first PC on my table, I was in Parliament, head of the computer IT division. So I got the first computer to see, what is this? The Windows was launched. Windows was new, though it was launched in 89, but it came to us in 91. and the first computer of parliament I took on my table, and I started learning Windows because nobody knew. So I was also new, and nobody else knew how to operate those Windows at all. Believe me, I closed my room for 2 days. I told my PA not to give me even calls, not allow anybody. And in those days, 2 days, I expertise those Windows. Just 2 days. Similarly, experiences of CDSISIS. I was to deliver a lecture in Shillong, and just on the aircraft itself for 2 hours, I was on my laptop and I learned practically CDSISIS. Of course, I knew DBAS at that time. So it was further version of, you can say, of the DBAS. So what I'm trying to say is technology is very simple. Don't think it is a complicated thing. It's something which is a, you know, like a huge thing. It is as simple as handling any other gadget, as handling a mobile. So please be friendly with technology. Think new and get new and new ideas. And believe me, one thing more. This technology is so friendly today that you imagine that I want to do something, this thing in the library. And then you start moving on to the system, talking to people or understanding to people, learning on the net and all. And you will find that there is already some open source software for that. There is some already, somebody has already implemented such kind of a thing. You can always ask them. You can always collaborate with them and learn from that. So get the ideas. Try to know what I have to do. Your job is, as a professional, is to think what I have to do. And then support of technology will be certainly available if you are friendly with the technology and if you are able to spend time with the technology. Similarly, one of your job is to help researchers. Now, researcher doesn't know how to look for the information, how to search the information, or even if he has searched some information, how to get an article, that particular article. If you are not subscribing to it, how you can get it. So this type of searching skills, the information search skills, they can be very easily developed by you. Only thing is, you have to spend time with the databases which you are subscribing. So there are data analysis. Now the next very important chapter, is a subject which librarians have to pick up, or librarian must pick up, is the data analysis, which is the need of the day. Now, what is the data? How data is organized? What are various software? So again, if you start involving yourself, it will be very simple. How to develop a depository of data? All these things you have to learn, and it's as simple as another thing. And one should learn, one should collaborate, one should learn from each other. So this is what I'm trying to give you a message today, is that don't be afraid of technology. Don't be afraid of new things. Don't be afraid of the new developments, but be partner with it. And where you are not able to understand, consult your colleagues. Talk to your friends. Talk to the system. Go to the people who are doing similar kind of jobs. That there are a lot of libraries at international level who are doing the similar kind of activities. Talk to them. And I tell you, I believe me, they all are ready to help you. They are ready to share their information, their experience, their expertise with you. So, and then be time ahead. I request you to look into what is artificial intelligence, what is data science, what is machine learning. Learn all these things now. This is the time for you. Now coming to the personal skills. Now these personal skills are very important. And the most important personal skill is you have to be visionary, creative, and innovative. This is the most important things which you have to do in your life. That your vision should be clear. You should be creative, always thinking something, always innovating something, working on something new. It is not that I become a dead kind of a thinker, dead person. That I call it a dead person if you are not doing anything creatively. If you are not doing anything, if you have no output, it is as good as a death. So come out, think, do something. It may work, it may fail, no problem. Have flexibility in your life. And most important, since a lot of young friends have joined me today, most important is communication skills. As Bill Gates has also said, if you remember, Bill Gates had said, he gives all the credit to two things. One is learning, reading books, and second is communication skills. Now, these are the skills which you have to pick up with the great, great dedication. I don't say if you speak good English, you have a good communication skills. No. This is part of communication skill. It's a very, very small portion of language. Language is a very small portion of the skill, communication skill. So, you have to pick up those, you have to become a very good communicator. I was about 2 months back, I was in a, you know, it is not only that you talk, but even you have to communicate in writing. Now, people come and tell me, sir, humne to apne principal se, humne vice chancellor se, dean se, I have said, you should, we should do this thing in library. We should use our social media in the library, but they don't agree. I said, then I asked them, how you told him? Sir, I met him 2-3 times and I told him. My dear friends, no system works like that. You have to make a proper project. You have to make a proper kind of a detailed project where you mention each and everything. What exactly is social media? How it can bring your readers close to your library and close to the librarian? What new services you will able to give if you implement this? What new ideas will be coming up? What will be the benefit to the institute? What will be the benefit to the library? What will be benefit to the user? What will be the cost? All these things you have to put it in black and white. And then if you make a presentation, believe me, things will go through. Only thing is, we have to be expert. We have to learn how to make this detailed proposal. I was in Gujarat University about 2 months back as a chief guest. And the vice chancellor openly in the hall said that you bring a detailed proposal. What I said just now. Mentioning that what is the concept, what exactly it will how it will benefit, what will be the negative points, what are the positive points, how it will, who will be the users, how it will be used, and what will be the cost. He says, rest is my problem. I will get you the money. I will get you the thing. Only thing is, your proposal has to be very concrete. Your proposal has to be very clear. If it is so, nobody can stop you. So we have to learn all these things. We have to learn how to talk, how to mix on one side. That means the verbal communication skills, the written communication skills. I have hundreds of stories in my career where the people with strong communication skills, especially the writing skills, succeeded in life. Even your consortia was almost, Infinite consortia was almost at dead end, but with those project proposed proper proposals and all, it went through. So this is how, there are a lot of things which are there, which can fetch you if your communication skills are strong. And next important is attitude. You have to be positive all the time. This negative, aray saab ye to ho nahi sakta. It is not possible. If I tell my, he will not agree. My principal will, my dean, my VC will not agree. My director will not agree. We start beginning with that only. And if you are feeling yourself like that, certainly it will not go through. Certainly nothing will happen.
Ravinder sir, I'm so sorry to bother you. But in your screen, there is this button called more.
Okay.
Just next to share screen,
okay,
there's this button called more. Just click on that.
Mm-hmm.
And share your screen and you will find the more button, sir.
One second. Again, I have to share the screen.
Yes, sir.
More button. Okay, where is this more button? Okay, new stop. Pause. More. Yeah, more. Yes.
Sir, click on disable attendee annotation.
Okay, disable participants annotate attendance or participants annotation, na?
Participants annotation. Yes, sir.
Okay, disable. Acha, that's why this was coming. Okay, okay, yes. Fine. Great. Thank you, dear.
Yes.
Okay. So attitude is very important. Attitude not only with the system, attitude among your friends, attitude among your family, attitude everywhere. A positive attitude will play a lot. If you hear Shivani, who is from Brahmakumari, I think she talks all the time about attitude on, positive attitude on. I can go on talking on all these things for hours together. Leadership. As I said in the beginning, leadership is not that leadership which we normally think of. Leadership is basically bringing out best from your friend, colleague, junior or senior. If you have leadership quality, if you are able to bring out best from your junior, from your senior or from your colleague, that everybody has some positive, some some aptitude is very good, somewhere is excellent, somewhere he may be normal. So those positive things, those things where he is excellent, if suppose he is good in writing, he is good in technology, he is good in, if you improve that, if you flourish that further, if you give a like a more kind of a boost to that, probably that is the leadership. The leadership is where you take your team together and come up with a work which work as a team, as a group, as a single member group. So teamwork is a part of leadership. Interpersonal relations are excellent. They are taken care. If somebody has a problem in family, you know, it's not a manager, certainly. There is a difference between managership and leadership. A manager, if suppose I have to go a little early today because I have to go to a doctor or I have to take my kid to the doctor, the manager's role will be, no, how it is possible, you can't go, or otherwise give me a half day leave or give me a short leave. But a leader will be, who will be passionate, who will understand your requirement, and he will give you, no, you must first attend to that and then come to office or then do this thing. And please, if you don't able to do it during office hours, do it in the night and come up with the things tomorrow. So this is the leadership quality. This is how you have to take your team together. You have to develop interpersonal relations. Your family, his family becomes your family problems. His family problems become your family problem. Now, these are the things which a leader has to pick up. So every one of you are a leader. Everyone is a leader. Everyone has to work together and give your best in the system, in the team. And let's go. Time management, motivational and all. I think Professor Jaideep will be able to cover a lot on this. I need not to go on because, I, as I said, I can talk hours together on that. As I said, communication skill is very important for me, for you, for everybody. Try to get expertise. There are a lot of ways to develop it. And if you want to learn and if you don't get the opportunity, the internet will give you the solutions also. There are solutions on the net itself. If I want to improve my spoken English, I can do. If I want to improve writing English, I can do. So all these things should be developed. As I said, continuous learning and sharing of knowledge is very important today. There was a survey where it says 43% of papers published in past 5 years were written by international research teams. That means the cooperation is not at local level, at the international level. The top papers are written by the teams which are at the different international level. So you have to learn to share, learn to collaborate. And that is important today. Let me go leave this because it's again a big list which can go. And I'll come to the end. I will say the Peter Drucker, who once believed, Peter Drucker is again a doyen of the management guru. And he said earlier he thought that we can manage all the people with one system. No. different people have to be managed differently. And that is the right
leadership.
My dear friends, you must pick up few things in life. Have passion towards your work. Keep on learning. Read every day. Even if you read 2 pages, fine. Look for changes. Embarrass changes. And think long term. Don't think of, worry about failures. It is not that, you know, it is not that you are only busy all the time for the work. You have to travel. You have to be positive. Take care of your health. These all are important things apart from, you know, working hard. And you have to remain fit because health is the most important thing in life. I'm not able to move the screen, my dear. Yeah, now it's okay. So, we must have inherent desire to obtain the new knowledge. We should look forward what new things can come. And just to end up, I would like to say, invest in developing communication skills. Follow your dreams. Make your goals, make your dreams, follow them, work hard for them. And develop coping mechanism, do yoga or whatsoever you do just to cope up with the the hardship or the hard conditions. And don't go into those jugaads kind of a thing. You should learn everything. The jugaad technology will never work in your life. It will not give you a long, long standing. Look into national level perspective or global perspective. And my personal life is different than the professional life. That is very important. If somebody has done some work, if somebody has implemented, say, let's say a very simple example. If somebody has, set up a kind of a the software, somebody has set up a kind of a Koha or something, I need not to learn the whole thing, how to set up Koha and all. I can always talk to him and get, you know, help from him to install the things. So don't go on reinventing the wheel. Start from where others have left. Go further. Don't leave your basics and life is with you. With that, I thank you very much. To give me, and especially to DLA for giving me this opportunity, and to all the friends who have joined me today afternoon, spend their valuable time. I understand about 500 people are there. So thank you very much, all the participants who have given their valuable time to me. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Mohit, am I audible? Sir. Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Loud and clear.
Okay. Thank you very much, sir. It was very nice, very, very nice. And it is really highly appreciated by the participants. They have used almost all the adjectives for your presentation. And particularly, I have learned certain very important things in my life. The sentence, invest in yourself. I think this is the most beautiful line which I have heard ever in my life. So this was really a very... a wonderful presentation, sir. Some of the things which I noted from the feedback of the audience, they said, we feel connected. One audience typed that, we feel connected, and one of them said, DLA rocked once again. So this kind of appreciations we had from the participants. This was really a wonderful talk, sir. Thank you very much. Now, before I go for the questions from the audience, I invite Mohit to interact for the audience for briefly, please. Mohit.
Sir, how long do I have?
Please, all the audience, please, you text your question and we will discuss on your question with the speaker. You have 5 to 7 minutes, Mohit.
Okay, sir. Bhavna, I request you to keep logging in all the questions in your diary. So once my presentation is done, we can relay those questions to the speaker, sir.
Okay. So Bhavna, please note down.
Yeah, we already have 2-3 questions. So I'll be very, very brief. I understand we have some experts with us who are very well versed with the technology aspect of, you know, library services, but we do have some young students, some young library professionals, and I think my presentation will give them some overview of how technology can assist libraries, especially in this lockdown period. So my company name is Refreed. We do customized digital library platforms for universities, colleges, government libraries, public libraries, some R&D labs, like all, the entire DRDO is using our platform. So when I started this company, I recognized the trend of libraries moving to electronic media, and there's a reason for that. In 2001, the first electronic journal was published. And in the span of last 17, 18 years, where we stand today, 90% plus journal, research journals or scholarly journal communication is now in electronic formats. Print journals only are consumed about 9 to 10%. In terms of books also, in last 7 or 8 years itself, the readership of ebooks has gone from 0 to 28%, and physical books are at around 72%. So the ebooks are also gaining a lot of momentum. News is probably the most drastic or most, it's the fastest growing media in electronic format. Between 2014 and 15, in just 1 year, the consumption of electronic news went from what it was in 2014 to about 4,000+%. So 4,000% increase was there in just 1 year. And libraries just cannot ignore these trends, this shifting of consumption of information. So what we see is that libraries are now shifting their budget, their content, their collection development strategies to electronic content. We see most of the universities, colleges now subscribing to a lot of databases, to a lot of ebook collections. I believe in most universities, the split in terms of budget on what they spend on print versus what they spend on digital, the ratio is close to 30% to 70%. In some universities, it's even more than that. However, getting this electronic content subscribed from publishers is only half the job. Because you get content from 25 publishers, we cannot expect our end users to go on 25 different websites to consume these journals and ebooks, right? We serve the Google generation, right? Our users are used to performing a single search and getting the content in front of them. Yeah. Nobody will go to 25 different platforms. So that is the first problem which we recognized in how universities are delivering the electronic content. Second trend we saw was that in today's time, the information needs are very diverse. Let us take the example of, let's say, DRDO. Okay, DRDO is a purely research organization. But as a library science professional, can I expect or can I assume that all the time my scientist will only be looking for a scholarly journal or a research journal? No. There will be times when he's probably looking for a Hindi classical literature. There will be times when a young research fellow will be not looking for a research article, but probably an expert talk. So the information needs are very diverse and they are not restricted to just journals and ebooks. And third trend we saw was the growth in consumption of information on mobile phones. sab bachcho ke paas laptop, ग्रेजुएट स्टूडेंट्स के पास लैपटॉप डेस्कटॉप ज्यादातर नहीं है. मैं टीयर टू टीयर थ्री सिटीज की बात कर रहा हूँ. वहां पर हमारे बच्चों के पास लैपटॉप डेस्कटॉप सब बच्चों के पास नहीं होता. बट इट इज फेयर टू से लास्ट 7 ईयर्स के अंदर जो मोबाइल फोन है, स्मार्टफोन है, इनकी पेनिट्रेशन बहुत ज्यादा बढ़ी है. तो वॉट वी सी इज दैट मोस्ट ऑफ दीज यूनिवर्सिटी एंड कॉलेज गोइंग स्टूडेंट्स हैव अ स्मार्टफोन. क्या हम अपनी लाइब्रेरी का एक्सेस, हमारे इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कंटेंट का एक्सेस मोबाइल फोन्स तक पहुंचा सकते हैं? ये तीन ट्रेंड मैंने रिकॉग्नाइज किए व्हेन आई स्टार्टेड दिस कंपनी. आई एम गोइंग टू टेक ओनली 2 to 3 minutes टुडे टू एक्सप्लेन माय प्रोडक्ट इन अ वेरी ब्रीफ बिकॉज आई डोंट वांट टू हाईजैक दिस सेशन. टुमारो आई विल एक्सप्लेन सम एडवांस फीचर्स. Can somebody please confirm if they can see my screen? Rajesh sir, it will be really nice of you if you can just confirm.
Yeah, it is visible.
Okay, sir. Thank you. So let us say this is one of the state universities. It's a very highly engaged university. Research output bhi achha hai. Inka consumption of e-resources bhi achha hai. But the problem they have, which most librarians will recognize, they will associate with, is that on the university website, they have a library page. And they have just listed the e-resources that this university has access to. राइट मैंने जो पहले बोला कि क्या बच्चे यहाँ से IEEE पर जाकर एक्सेस करेंगे फिर ASME पर जाकर फिर टेलर एंड फ्रांसिस पर सो दिस वॉज काउंटर प्रोडक्टिव सो वॉट वी डिड वॉज वी बिल्ट दिस डिजिटल लाइब्रेरी प्लेटफॉर्म आई विल जस्ट डू अनदर फ्रेश लॉग इन या एज लॉन्ग एज मैं इस e-library प्लेटफॉर्म पर लॉग्ड इन हूं आई विल हैव एक्सेस टू इंटायर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्टेंट दैट दिस यूनिवर्सिटी हैज आई कैन ब्राउज द इंटायर कॉन्टेंट बाय डिसिप्लिन बाय पब्लिशर बाय फॉर्मैट एंड द लाइब्रेरियन कैन ऑल्सो क्रिएट सम टॉपिक कलेक्शंस जेसी बोस यूनिवर्सिटी ने वो फैकल्टी नोट्स की कलेक्शन बनाई है सो लेट्स से आई एम लुकिंग फॉर एल्जेवियर जर्नल्स आई क्लिक ऑन एल्जेवियर जर्नल्स I get the listing here, whatever is subscribed by the library. I click on the journal. Zyadatar electronic publishers restrict access on a public IP address, right? So, aaj ke time mein, COVID mein, jab humare campus mein bachche aa hi nahi rahe hain, toh wo electronic content use kaise karenge? So, this platform, mera e-library platform has an inbuilt remote access layer, which automatically authenticates the user on publisher website. So currently I am not sitting in YMCA right now, but Elsevier Science Direct recognizes me as a user of JC Bose and will always give me full text access. Main hamari electronic subscriptions ko duniya mein kahin se bhi access kar sakta hu. So the remote access is inbuilt. I can download the PDF. So basically jaisa mujhe campus ke andar access milta mere electronic resources ka now have a global access of all the electronic resources through this e-library platform. I do a search. I've searched for nanotechnology. Library mein jitni bhi subscriptions related to nanotechnology hain, wo mere paas surface out ho gayi. Hamare paas, Refereed ke paas 20 lakh, 2 million full text publications ki collection hai. In English, Hindi or in Indian languages. Ye sara humne subject classify kiya hua hai. And this entire open access collection also we put in these digital libraries. Toh maine bhi nanotechnology par search kiya tha. Toh jo bhi related publications hai, 207 publications related to nanotechnology, I get them on the platform. I can even look for research articles. So instead of going to IEEE and then Science Direct and then different other platforms, now I have brought in the results from all the different platforms to my e-library itself. मेरे को अलग-अलग जगह जाके सर्च करने की ज़रूरत नहीं है। एक बार मैं आपको इस लाइब्रेरी का इस एक सिंगल इंस्टेंस का पूरा ब्रेड दिखाना चाहूँगा। So if you look at this e-library, there are 6,48,000+. Mute everyone. Yeah. So there are 6,48,000+ full text publications, out of which 29,000 odd are subscribed by the library, but we have added about 6,00,000+ full text publications on the e-library. Right? So collection aapka hazaron se lakhon mein pahunchane mein bhi we also help. Second aspect jo maine baat kiya tha ki hamesha user sirf scholarly content nahi dekh raha hoga. So, जब भी हम e-library बनाते हैं, we make sure that there are some engaging information services added on the platform. Like in this case, there is a collection of expert talks. There's a collection of literature. About 2,000+ literature titles we have in Hindi, English, Urdu, Punjabi. We are slowly building this collection. And in fact, we are now in partnership with 50+ news publications. So instead of going to different platforms, now the e-library also serves headlines from 50 plus news publications, and users can create news alerts. Unko e-library par bhi aane ki zarurat nahi hai. If I want to have access to all the news articles related to COVID-19, I just do confirm. And tomorrow onwards, the platform will start sending me news related to COVID-19 straight to my email inbox. So, मैंने एक छोटा सा एक brief दिया है platform का in 5 minutes. So the problem that we solve is bringing in all your e-resources on a common platform.
मेरे को कल ही खाने मेरे लिए तो आधा किलो बहुत है.
Making sure that all the e-resources are brought on a common platform. And then they are delivered to users globally. Users can access them from anywhere across the globe 24/7. So that's the first problem that we have solved, which I was trying to explain today. We will come back to you tomorrow after the session with some more advanced features which we have built on this e-library, and it is unique to us. Sir, back to you.
Thank you, Mohit. Thank you very much. Please remove your slide. Now I hand over to Bhavna. You have the questions, please. Speak the questions one by one, and I request the speaker to respond to the queries, please.
Yes, please.
Hello. Good evening, everyone. I have all the questions written with me, so I'm going one by one.
Bhavna, you do one thing. If there are similar questions, you put them together.
Okay, sure, sir. No, I'm not repeating any questions. I have all written in separately. So question number one, which we have received from Shikha Bhargava, which is, please suggest guidelines for the functioning of school library in post-COVID-19 period.
Great. Again, education system has changed, will be changing a lot. Can I take 2 minutes to give you a very interesting story? There is a university in France where there is no teacher at all. The student get the admission, and after getting the admission, they enter into a swimming pool. That means it's not an actual swimming pool, it's a virtual swimming pool. That means they are given certain assignment and they work on those assignments. The assignments come automatically through artificial intelligence system. And then after they get the admission, for 4 years, there is no teacher in this university. All the projects which you do is reviewed by your peers. That means all other students review your projects. You learn from each other experience. And this particular university, the students get the job opportunity before completing their 4-year course. Normally at 3 years, 3.5 years, they get the job opportunity. And none of the students till now is without an excellent job. So this is the future of education, where the education will be done either, you know, either sitting, you know, at a remotely, like what we are doing today under webinars. Today, what I see is all the students are taking classes at home, and the teacher is talking either on Zoom or some other platform, and then the classes goes on. Now, once we are in this kind of a scenario, now the advantage of this scenario is the student is learning of his own pace, his or her own pace. You know, in a class, what happens is certain students are very fast, certain students are mediocre, certain students are slow. But here, everybody can spend, you know, learn at his own pace. They can go keep on experimenting the things. They keep on learning by doing. Gamification is the major mode. Now, in the school, again, the school education system will again have a system where the gamification will be more prominent. The kids will be learning through games. Kids will be learning through stories. Kids will be learning through kind of a non-traditional modes. So this is how the school education will change. Now here the role of librarian becomes very important, because the librarian now can be a key player in the school education system. Not only in school, I'm talking about academic libraries. The libraries will, you know, this is basically, I call it a golden opportunity for academic libraries, where they can switch over to their total role as a mentor, as an organizer, as a space provider. A student who is not able to, you know, do the things at his home, maybe he comes to the library. A library provides him an individual room. Library provides him a room where 5-6 students can sit, class fellows can sit. A library can provide a room where 20 students can sit. Now they can discuss among each other, or even there is some kind of a help is required from the library side or from the teacher side that can be provided. So library becomes a very key position in e-education 4.0 environment. This is the time when academic libraries should totally revolutionize. And then how we can provide them tailor-made material for the courses which they are learning. Suppose I pick up a project, I have picked up a chapter. How the library can support the educational material, the background material. The person should not be dependent on the Google, or should not be dependent on searching and all these things. So library comes here, who provides them the kind of a tailor-made material, the authentic material. What is available on Google is said that almost 40% is not correct or fake sometimes. 80% of political information is fake. These are the surveys. I'm not saying that. These are the surveys. So the kids have to be saved from this wrong information, incorrect information, the fake information. That is the traditional role of the library also, and the modern role of the library. So our role is not changed. The ways have changed. The means have changed. Earlier we were doing it, what was the book selection? Book selection means you select an authentic book. You select a book which is published by a renowned author, which is a correct book. Same way, the electronic way you have to do it. So your role totally becomes very important, very useful in the new COVID, after COVID-19 era. Yes, please. Is it okay or something else is needed?
No, it's fine, sir. Bhavanaji, next question.
Yes. Yes, sir. Next question is, somebody asking about what is blockchain?
Oh, see, one thing, even I am not expert on that, but what is, this is a kind of a technology where things are divided into, all the information or all the data is divided into small bits and bytes. And then they move from different sources and then they are able to unite and get you that information or data. So this technology allows you to maneuver a lot of things. Like, the currency came into, the blockchain provided the currency system where the money can move from one source to another source without being known to anybody or so. So this is a new technology which can help in a lot of materials. I don't know how it will be helping in libraries because I have not also gone through it in much detail. But this is an upcoming technology which will be certainly used in many aspects. But since I am not much aware on this, I can't go on talking on that. Yes.
Thank you, sir. Next, Bhavana, the next.
Yes. So next question is from Ms. Anuradha, and she asked how to tackle staff members who put their work on you so that you don't get any time and demoralize you constantly.
Yes, this is very interesting. This is very, very interesting thing, the staff handling and all, and very practical. I'll give you a very interesting example and then I'll come answer your question. When I was working in the computer center, I was head of the computer center in Parliament, four girls joined. Now these four young girls joined as a data entry operator or typist, whatsoever you call. And within 15 days, since none of them wanted to work on the computers, they all put some or other bahana to not to work on the computer. One girl was pregnant. She got a certificate from the doctor that sitting in front of computer screen may, impact, have radiation impact on the kid. Another said, my eyes are weak, and she brought a certificate from the doctor that my eyes are weak and I can't sit in the front of computer screen for many hours. Third one also came with something and all this thing. Now it was problem for me. New girls joined and they don't want to work. What I did was, first I tried to motivate them, told them and all, but didn't work. So what I did was, one of the girl who was little kind of a, you know, kind of a supportive or who wanted to work on it, I called her. I said, you start working. We have a quota system in the parliament where one has to type 32 pages every day. That is the minimum output should be there of a typist. So I said, you start typing on the computer. I will not insist on 32 pages. And please start it, you know. And two other girls, three girls, I started giving about 50 pages per day for typing. Because I tried my best for motivating them and all. Since I failed on that, I started this trick. I initiated this trick. So what happened, this girl who was on the computer, she was having less work, less pressure and all. So after some time, one more girl came and said, sir, I will also like to work on computer. Mujhe kaam dena shuru kar di. So she, and slowly all the four, you know, they changed because they realized working on computer is much simpler as compared to work on a typewriter where I have to type almost 50 pages a day. And since I didn't have an input for 50 pages, I have to, you know, did something like half of the pages I used to throw in the waste paper also. So issue is, what I'm trying to say is, I tried a trick where finally they, you know, agreed. Finally, they worked. And after 1 year, when I asked, can I give you typewriters back? And they said, sir, how it is possible? Thoda thodi chala sakte hum. So what I'm trying to say is, you have to be firm with your staff. Try to motivate them. Try to tell them that this is your work. You have to do in a perfect condition. It is not that you just say, I don't know this. I can't do this. Try to work with them. And if they don't change, if their behavior is not, because that's what I said. There are few people who will never change, who will never do this. So then we have another things, how administratively we can take that, how administratively we can play that things, because after all, you have administrative powers with you. And you have to, you know, like them, tell them very in clear terms that this is how you have to learn, this is how you have to work, and this is what is the institute demands for you. So this certainly has to be a firmness. Of course, we are a team, we are a group, but the shirkers have no opportunity to be in the team, to be part of the team which has to give the output. So you have to be firm on those people. And I'm sure you will face this. Now, there's another thing. As I said, there are few people who are ready to accept certain kind of work, who are very good in that particular job. So identify among those group that who is good in what. What we try to do, no, you are junior library assistant, you have to do this. But if his or her passion is something else, see if he can give better output in that. So here you have to be considerate. Here you have to be working very closely with the team and then look into it, irrespective of their position, irrespective of that if they are enjoying certain kind of a work, give them that work, give them that option. Okay, you look into this because you enjoy this. So that way you can build your team, build your strong team, because that's how you will able to get the maximum output from your team. So on one side, you have to get their best out of them, because you have to see what good, you know, in what part they are good, look into that. And another side, if they are not again amending, they're not changing their behavior. So we have administrative issues with us. That's how one has to work.
Sir, I would like to add something from your lecture itself.
Yes, dear.
Hello.
Yes, dear. Yes, carry on.
One has to lead as a leader from the front.
Correct.
What I learned from your lecture, sir.
Right.
Bhavanaji, next question.
Yes.
And we go for only two more questions, please.
So, sir, the next question is, how machine learning technology is going to help in librarianship?
All technologies are going to help. You have to keep on, you know, looking into the usefulness in your own. See, I'll tell you one thing very important and which one should learn, you know. Don't try to copy. Don't try to see that he has done this thing, I should also do. Every institute has its own requirement. Every organization needs, it's working in a very different way. In fact, I had that slide in my presentation. But then I realized time is too short, I removed it. See, you have to pick up best what it suits to your organization. It is not that somebody has used Koha, I should also use Koha. Somebody has done this thing, I should also do this thing. Like somebody is subscribing e-resources, I should also. in parliament, I never went for RFID for the library. There was RFID used in each and every aspect of parliament. Our security system, where I was the key technical person, where I supported RFID-based entry exit system, the vehicle entries through RFID, the person entries through RFID, but in library, I never put RFID. Thinking it will be spending too much, and money is not a problem for me. Money was never a problem. Thinking I will be spending a lot of money and output will be less. So it is not for the sake of RFID that to say in the public, oh, I have done my RFID in the library. I have to do it. If there is a requirement of any technology, anything, then you should go about it. You should assess each and everything before implementing it, whether it is useful or whether it is worth putting the efforts, time, energy, money or so. So it is not that somebody has done, I should also do. So look into the usefulness, look into the priorities of the institute, and then go for it. If you have a huge number of students and you are, whom you want to connect, you want to get feedback and ideas and all these things, then you should go for certain social media kind of. But otherwise, putting your library on social media where you don't expect much response or much this thing, so why should you do it? So it is all based on the requirement of your library. It's not blindly that I do this, he has done, I should also do. Do minimum things, but do in a best possible way, in an exemplary way, and go into the depth of that. And do it in the best possible way. Okay? Yes, please.
So the next question is, somebody asked that PDF form mein hum newspaper collection bana sakte hain kya libraries?
Kyun nahi bana sakte? Aap bana sakte hain apni library mein jo collection, जो भी आप न्यूज़पेपर सब्सक्राइब करते हैं उसको अगर आप पीडीएफ फॉर्म में रखना चाहते हैं, यू आर अंडर द मिलेनियम, व्हाट इज दैट, मिलेनियम कॉपीराइट एक्ट, यू कैन कीप अप टू 2 कॉपीज इन द लाइब्रेरी फॉर द यूज विद इन द लाइब्रेरी और फॉर द यूज ऑफ योर यूजर्स ऑफ द इंस्टीट्यूट, यू कैन मेक कॉपीज. तो आप पीडीएफ क्या किसी भी फॉर्मेट में रखिए और आप उस कॉपीज को डिजिटल फॉर्म में स्टोर कर सकते हैं. This is under copyright law. It is purely allowed.
Fine. Sir, there are some common questions. Yes, sir.
Okay, Bhavna. You take up one more question.
Jitne bhi questions hain, apart from that, if we are able to, mera email address maine uspe diya tha, presentation ke shuru mein tha. You can write, send me an email. I have no problem. Any kind of question related to this lecture or otherwise, any kind of a thing, please write to me. I'll be very happy to answer you. There's no issue at all. Yes, you can take one or two more questions. If time
sir, the next questions are basically for Rajesh, sir, because they are common questions.
Bhavna, before I take your question, I think I have my own plans.
Okay, sure.
And if I address the audience, those questions will be resolved.
Sure.
Okay. So kindly allow me.
Yeah, sure.
Before I proceed for a vote of thanks, there are some announcements for the audience. Please remember, this is a series of webinar, and you all are registered for all 4 days. You all are registered for all 4 days, whether you have selected one option or other option. So please be in time. We have a lot number of people who have registered, which is around 1,300. So if you are in time, you will be in the webinar. Otherwise, you will have to view the live streaming. Yes, we will be giving e-certificate once this series is complete. We will provide e-certificate to each and every one of you. But my suggestion to you people, since you all are young people and you are the future of library profession, see, what kind of speakers are speaking to you. They are putting all their experience, all their knowledge to enlighten you. So please learn also, and certificates will definitely give to everyone. Please behave yourself during the webinars. If your mic is on, you might not be speaking, but any kind of noise from your back or from somewhere near you will be disturbing regularly. So please, this is a courtesy to the speaker that we keep our mic muted every time. So all of you are required to participate. Yes, we have a feedback form and we will be sending you the feedback form. You have to fill up that feedback form once, not every day, only once. And that is a very well planned feedback form, not only for this webinar, but for all the webinars you have attended. So we will be sending you the feedback form. Please cooperate with us. Tomorrow we have equally important speaker, Professor Jaideep Sharma. He will be speaking to you on similar lines, on similar skills and attitude of young professionals. So please be on time and join the program. This is customary and this is for the day, not for the entire webinar. This is for the day. I extend my thanks to the speaker. Sir, hum aapke hriday se aabhari hain. He managed to spare some time on our request from his busy schedule for this webinar. We are grateful to you, sir. I express my thanks. I extend thanks from the entire DLA team, from the president and everyone. We are thankful and we are honored that you have delivered such a wonderful speech today. Even not only the participants, most of us learn from it. So thank you very much, sir. I also need to thank the host of this program, the president of DLA. In fact, this program was prepared in a very short period of time, but I am thankful for all his help. Even he was ready to take a call at 11 o'clock in the night or even beyond that. So and he used to talk me regularly and everything we consult together. Thank you very much, sir. I also extend my thanks to my co-convener, Dr. J.N. Singh. He has extended all possible help. So thank you to you, Dr. Janin. And the last one is my lovely audience. There were some miscreants, those who were trying to blur the screen otherwise. All the audience is really a very nice audience. Besides participating in the program, I was keeping a close watch on their feedback on the text they were messaging. And thank you to all of you from every nook and corner from the country. Thank you for your response and thank you for your joining. Thank you very much to all of you. This is not the last, but again, I need to thank the referee, the CEO, Mr. Mohit Sharma. He's an old friend of mine. And he accepted our request on a very short notice of time. So thank you to you, Mohit. We are really very thankful to you for extending all support, all help to DLA and to this webinar. Thanks to all of you.
All yes. Service.
Thank you. Thank you, Mohit. Thanks to all of you, please. Thank you very much.
Thank you, DLA.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you.
We will again meet at 3:50 tomorrow for the next session. We will be sending the meeting details on email to all of you. Have a good day. Take care of yourself. Stay safe.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.